Okay, let's shift focus now to what really is happening in some of the insecticide spaces. And, you know, it's important to gather what the demand outlook is for the current Kharif season, the product launches which are there in the pipeline, and the kind of margin improvement and profit growth one can see. Insecticides India, Rajesh Agarwal, the MD, joins us on the show right now. We also have with us another very special guest joining in right now. And that, of course, is, the kind of impact that we would see from this entire shift to GST as well, the unorganized to organized play. Siddharth Mundra, CEO at Shankara Building Products, would be joining us later. But we also have with us Mr. Ramesh Chand, who's the member at Niti Aayog, joining in on the show right now. Gentlemen, morning. And if I could come to you, Rajesh, firstly, right now. Tell us a little bit more about how the quarter has panned out so far, because the last time when we chatted with you, you were pretty upbeat with half a dozen planned product launches for the Kharif season. Tell us a little bit more about how this revitalization of rural India is panning out now that we have a good monsoon as well at our hands.
Yeah, after 2 years, this has been a very good rainfall. So I believe that this is going to be a very good season. I can say that the rains have started pan-India, and overall all the farmers are going to get this benefit. Though there has been confusion due to the change in policy and markets were practically not functioning well during this time, but I still believe that we have shown a very good growth in the first quarter actually, and the numbers would be coming out soon. And I believe that now, since there was this confusion period, so the bills were not happening for 4 or 5 days, and there was a lot of panic in the market because of huge demand actually. So I believe that second quarter again is going to be upbeat quarter, and we believe particularly in agriculture sector actually, there should be a good growth.
Let me also encourage Dr. Ramesh Chand, member Niti Aayog, to join in and share his thoughts on A, revitalizing rural India, and B, what is going to be the impact of good monsoon. Now, Dr. Chand, for the second year on the trot now, we will have abundant, decent and good rainfall. What to your mind that could do to demand immediately is what I want to understand. Because last year, the demand never came back in full bloom, because 2014 or 2015 was a year of poor monsoon. 2016 was decent, and 2017 is where the flourish will happen.
Yeah, you see, in agriculture, things even out. We had two bad years, and then hopefully we will have second good year for agriculture. Last year we expected, and the first estimate has also come, that the growth rate will be touching 5%. And with the good rainfall this year and other indicators showing that this year also we are likely to achieve good growth in agriculture. Concerns have been expressed about demand side. You see, if you look at market behavior previous Kharif season and Rabi season, you will find that in some of the crops we witnessed glut, but those gluts were temporary and those gluts were localized. But we need to reckon one trend in agriculture which is getting stronger, that farmers are now responding to prices very strongly, and we are seeing that there is a big shift toward cash crops. To handle these kind of things, we have been proposing that we need to have some different kind of mechanism. We need to put in place new institutions which are very important. Like, if you look at prices of tomato in the month of May, it was very low in the major producing regions. But you look at prices of tomato in the month of June, in many states it doubled. In all the states, the increase within 1 month is not less than 70% in any place. Then secondly, we also found that while there was a price crash in some mandis, tomato was still selling at high prices in other places. But I want to say is that there is a demand in the country. 5% growth rate in agriculture can be easily absorbed by the rising demand in the country. But we need to pay attention to market integration, that we need to smoothen supply, we need to ensure that that prices come to some sort of equilibrium between deficit region and the surplus regions. There are other things also. I intentionally gave this example of tomato, and I think same thing we are going to witness in the case of onion. That with farmers responding to prices very strongly necessitate that we need to have a large storage facility, we need to have processing facilities, because these are the hallmark of commercial agriculture. So you will find that that in the past we used to have glut only in some commodity and some small place. But now you just find that the places where this glut kind of situation happen and shortage kind of situation happen, that number is rising, and that suet is also becoming stronger. So it is obvious when the agriculture change in this kind of direction, which is happening in our country. But I will say that that we need to respond to it by changing our system of marketing, by our infrastructure and other facilities.
Dr. Chand, the government announced in last budget that the goal of doubling farmer income in 5 years is going to take place. How achievable is it looking like in comparison to the trend that we've seen last few years?
You see, the after government set this goal, we had this first year 16-17, and I find that the ground has been laid for doubling of farmer income. The very fact that the value added in agriculture is estimated to grow by 5%, that itself is a significant contribution to the towards achieving this goal. And secondly, we looked at roadmap for doubling income, farm income, that major contribution will be of diversification, that farmer shifting from low value crop toward high value crop. And the preliminary or the early estimate shows that that has also started happening. In case of prices, if we look at the overall agriculture prices, we generally compare with what was year prices in year 15-16, which was extraordinarily abnormal year, not good for comparison. But if you look at prices of agriculture and in relation to the general price index, then you will find that there is a slow growth in agriculture prices, but non-agriculture prices, the growth is still slower. So in real term, you will just find that it's not negative, it's a small positive kind of things. There were other things also in doubling of farmer income, with the major emphasis on market, that states must change their market act. The new situation requires that all India is one market. All India one market is not possible if we are not putting in place e-NAM, electronic national agriculture market, or that electronic portal, online bidding kind of things. And also, if we are not promoting direct sale, if we are not letting private sector to come into agriculture market. So if we are restricting that only the local trader will buy, they will buy through the physical auction kind of things, then you will find that achieving this goal will become very difficult. So I would say that 16-17 has been favorable, and 17-18 from production point of view also looks like favorable for achieving this goal. But now markets must play their due role. because the strongest effect on income comes from the prices.
So
and we have suggested to state
right.
a reform agenda for agriculture markets. They should come immediately with that.
Okay. Rajesh, I'm coming back to you right after this question. And, you know, Dr. Chand, I know you have an appointment. So I'll ask my next question will be the last question to you. What is your initial sense as part of Niti Aayog onto what could be the crop production levels this year? Which are some of the key producers where because of good monsoon, better irrigation and better sowing, you think the production levels could be significantly different than 2015 and 16?
No, you see, we should be comparing with 16 and 17 now, because we are now in 17 and 18. Certainly, 15, 16 was a very bad year. The growth rate was either zero or it was slightly negative. So, in 16, 17, the CSO estimate is that agriculture sector growth will be 4.9%. And I feel that with the tempo already set and with the monsoon looking favorable and various development initiative like Pradhan Mantri, Krishi Sinchai Yojana, Fasal Bima Yojana put in place, I feel that this year our agriculture growth rate should also be more than 4%.
Dr. Chand, appreciate your time. Thank you for joining us. And Rajesh, whatever you've heard from Dr. Chand up until now should be music to your ears. Your business is a function of agrarian demand. And agrarian demand this year, according to the estimates, is likely to make a comeback of about 5 to 6%. So can you broadly give me some numbers that if the agrarian demand comes back, if there's better crop, if there's better, you know, sowing, how does life change for an agri product company like Insecticide India?
It's a good opportunity, I would say, after some time, because the years were full of struggle in the past, and this year we already plan a launch actually of various products actually, and some of them are already launched into the market and some of them will be coming in this current month and the next month actually. So we are very, very bullish about this year actually, and I believe that in the past 2 years our growth was a little slow, and this year we should see we should make a recovery actually, what we could not, because generally we wish to double ourselves in 4 to 5 years. So that slowed down in past 2 years, though last year we had about 12% growth, but a year before showed a single digit percentage growth actually. So I believe that this is the year to make the recovery.
So Rajesh, in bad years, you've managed to grow at about 15%. Now, this is going to be a good year, not a good year, a bumper year. Can I imagine that you're likely to grow at least at 25%? Because your aim is 20%, we know that aim. But things have changed after that.
Agriculture is very, very vulnerable to monsoons and a lot of effects actually. So the beginning is very good and we can hope this. But it depends on the outcome, that how the monsoon is behaving in different parts of the country, how the areas or regions are getting the rainfall. If everything is good, yes, 25% is achievable. It is not very difficult. But if there is some difficult circumstances, yeah, we may end up around 20. So it is very early to comment, because the season practically starts from July and it is a beginning. I see a good outcome, a good onset of the season actually. But yes, I'll be able to respond this very minutely by end of August actually, I believe. But things look positive, I would say.
Okay. Gentlemen, appreciate your time. So glad that you could.